Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you end fire antenna array and broadside antenna array. So here we are a little bit to see how end fire antenna array radiates in the space, as well as I'll explain you how broadside antenna array radiate in the space. So here, first of all, if you talk about end fire antenna array, then based on name itself, you can understand how radiation is happening. See, here we have antenna array and this is antenna axis, right? So here antenna array that is arranged horizontally. So horizontal axis, that is antenna axis. And if you observe the radiation pattern, then see radiation pattern that is happening at angle theta is equals to 0. And at theta is equals to 180 degree. So in end fire antenna array, radiation happens at theta is equals to 0 degree and at theta is equals to 180 degree. So with end fire antenna array, maxima location that is there at theta is equals to 0 degree and at theta is equals to 180 degree means radiation is happening along the axis of antenna array. Right. When you talk about broadside antenna array, then here you can observe we have antenna array and this is what axis of antenna array and radiation is happening with 90 degree angle with respect to axis of antenna. So in broadside antenna array, maxima location that is there at theta is equals to 90 degree. So based on radiation mechanism of end fire antenna array and broadside antenna array, we can identify some interesting parameters. See, in my last video, I have explained you calculation of array factor and I have derived array factor for n element array, right? So here we have n elements for which I have derived array factor equation, that is sine of n psi by 2 divided by sine of psi by 2. Where value of psi is beta d cos theta plus alpha, where d is spacing between two elements, beta is 2 pi by lambda, alpha is initial phase in between two elements, right? So based on array factor equation, let us identify parameters of end fire array. Array factor for n elements is sine of n psi by 2 divided by sine of psi by 2, where value of psi is beta d cos theta plus alpha. See, here beta is 2 pi by lambda, d is spacing between two elements, this alpha is initial phase in between second element with respect to first element, right? And this theta, that is direction of radiation for maxima, right? See, here if you observe this array factor equation, sine of n psi by 2 divided by sine of psi by 2, then principal maxima that will happen at psi is equals to 0, right? So for principal maxima with array factor, psi is equals to 0. So here psi is equals to 0 and value of theta that is happening at 0 or 180 degree, right? And as I have told you, psi is how much? Psi is beta d cos theta plus alpha, right? So here you can say 0, that is psi, that is equals to beta d cos theta, where theta value can be 0 or 180 degree, right? Plus alpha. So if you take this alpha on other side, then alpha is equals to minus beta d cos of 0 or 180 degree angle. If you place cos 0, it will be plus 1. And if you place cos 180, it will be minus 1. So you can say alpha value, that is plus or minus beta d, right? Alpha value, that is plus or minus beta d for end fire array. So initial phase in between consecutive element, that has to be plus or minus beta d for end fire radiation pattern of an element array. Right. Now, if you want to derive relation of alpha for broadside array, then same thing that we need to do. As I have told you, array factor for n element array is sine of n psi by 2 divided by sine of psi by 2, where value of psi is beta d cos theta plus alpha, right? And principal maxima that will happen at psi is equals to 0, right? And with broadside array, see theta is equals to 90 degree. With broadside array, theta is equals to 90 degree, right? If you substitute these values in this equation of psi, then psi is 0, that is equals to beta d cos 90 plus alpha. Cos 90 is 0, so you can say alpha is equals to 0. So if you wanted to have broadside array radiation pattern, if you wanted to have this radiation pattern, which is broadside radiation pattern where theta is equals to 90 degree, at the time condition is alpha should be 0, right? And in case of end fire radiation pattern, in case of end fire radiation pattern, value of alpha that should be plus or minus beta d. That is how one can have broadside and end fire radiation pattern for n element antenna arrays. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you would like to share, then note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.